Sweet, sort of. First of all, if you're asking for the chapter, sorry, I cannot give it to you. You have to find it yourself. Second of all, this is all about Weiss, or Arsenal as he likes to call himself, into that suit. He really genuinely believed he was a masked superhero. I didn't know that young Weiss had such an interest for heroes. So this is action-packed. The only real grip is the beginning. Why is Madame Kudenai overpowering Shiki? He is supposed to be the main character! Something as big as a robot is supposed to be nothing compared to him. And while you're asking that, if you're telling me that is the most dumbest thing I ever heard, then I'm saying to you, you clearly have forgotten how Hiromashima writes his heroes. Their strength knows no limit. Enough about that. The angry enemy and the despair reviewer hear about this. First off, a sexy cover page. We see Witch without her lips. I mean makeup on her lips. In a nice new suit, exposes once again her cleavage, and a little bit legs. The manager of Eden Zero, which of the four stars shines? Be careful not to become a little pawn. That is funny. Either way, the beginning of this chapter is of course Madame Kurnai going all insane as she just keeps on blaming everything else. It's worth noting that Shiki even stops some rumbles that falls down so that it doesn't well fall on people. This contradicts a little bit on what he said before. You know, he said before to guards or whatever that he's no hero of justice, and if his friends are in trouble, he has no problem becoming a demon king. Which means that it has a little bit more anti-heroic than Hiromashima's previous heroes. However, it's still worth noting that even so, he still doesn't like that innocent people get hurt. So maybe it's just that if his friends are in danger, or if his innocent people are in danger, I think he prioritizes his friends over the people. Either way, it's the fact that Madame Kurenai tries to punch Shiki and crush him with the stone rock. I am a bit pissed off that Shiki seems to be on the defensive here. Either way, but it's very clear though that Madame Kurenai, she has completely snapped. Regardless, the rest of the chapter is all about Weiss, or as he likes to call himself, Arsenal in that bodysuit. That suit of armor looks very familiar in a way. Maybe it reminds me of those mooks from Tartaros in Fairy Tail. Either way, both Rebecca and of course Pino all knows that that is Weiss, but he still tries to act dumb. Even though Rebecca plays along, please, Arsenal, protect us. He just says, one condition, wear that skimpy maid dress from the dress factory. Even in this situation, he can't help but being perverted. He then calls the beast diviner Monster Lion Baron, and then proclaims to do many said time moves for the sake of love and justice. I won't forgive those that does evil. Of course, though, before Weiss can even finish his words, the Punisher just hits him with the axe, but luckily the armor prevents him from being killed. It's just the fact it's against the rules to axe someone when they're still talking. Yeah, I don't really understand those rules. That is kind of funny. I mean, granted, it's not comedy gold, but I think that is meant to lampshade the enormously big cliche that I can also admit it also exists in my stories. And what I mean my stories is that on my free time I tend to write fiction a lot. So these situations are actually similar. I've written something similar here about you were just wide open there, or why are you even talking? In a way, this is exactly what the Beast Man is saying here. Either way, after a dumb that scene, he decides to become serious, as Weiss reveals that he also has his orders, actually from Witch, to save them all. Because it turns out that Witch, not Witch, sorry, Sister. Because it turns out that Sister actually has an extreme soft spot for Rebecca. Almost to the point where I actually wonder, is that ambitious lesbian attraction, or is this just cuteness? Well, I don't know. It's worth noting though that Sister talks like a man. So, you know, I'm just saying. I hope that is not a man android that became a female one, if you wonder if that is the reason why she talks that way, because I certainly hope it's not like that. But for some strange reason I can't shake this fear that it may be that way. But regardless, that's not the point. The cuteness of it all is the fact that she feels like Rebecca is more important than Moskoi. which he takes a little bit offensive to. And the fact that he has even managed to make Rebecca her screensaver. Either way, Weiss feels that Erotic, together with the Hermito, has actually managed to create the special Arsenal suit first edition. Which says, while exposing her very long, muscular legs, that this is an order, bring them all back safely. Of course, she includes the others as well, but she prioritized Rebecca. Either way, the rest of it is a fight, and I have to say it's nice fights, as we see the suit of armor that can fire many different weapons. The Arsenal suit is powerful because it utilizes the power of Weiss's ether gear. As you all remember, using his ether gear, he can change weapons into anything, and given to the fact that he's now dressed into a fuller armor, he can change weapons into from the fly, which makes it more amazing. Even though that the Beastman is still very fast, Arsenal is also still fast. But then suddenly, what it looks like Arsenal is having an advantage, it turns out that the suit is having a limit. Apparently, the more ether it burns out, it will eventually burn out. Again, not exactly an explanation on how all of this ether really works, but I get it. It's a super powerful suit, so it makes sense that someone as Weiss cannot use it immediately. From the beginning, it almost sounded like he can only use it this one time. Hermito did call it first edition, probably implying that they can't upgrade it. Granted, it's a weapon, and any weapon can be upgraded every single time. So, it's also worth noting that this suit, while maybe a little bit inspired by some designs from previous Hiromashima work, we cannot deny that it also has very strong Iron Man-like references, especially when the suit is being shut down, the voice that's talking that way, and especially the, light inside the mask, makes this remarkably very similar to when Tony Stark always used to talk to Jarvis. Either way, before his suit runs out, Weiss uses all of his rest of his power to create a super powerful punch that he knocks out the one, as he proclaims that you will be part of Arsenal's first legend. My legend is just about to begin. As he creates an attack that also is a very huge tribute to Fairytale. Do you know what the name of that attack is? Metallica Explosion. Something very similar to Metallicana, who were the dragon of iron in Fairytale. Either way, with one powerful punch there, after having punched around the Beastmen, he is finally defeated. So, in case you are protesting, this is not a one-hit KO, okay? He punched him a little bit, he just used one final attack to finally finish it off. Either way, the suit deactivates, and so it, turns back into a wrist. But then it turns out that, Weiss was naked underneath that armor. Apparently not even having underwear, because, he didn't take in consideration that Arsenal would fall off. You know? What kind of a man does not at least wear underwear when they have some kind of armor? Either way, but unfortunately the chapter ends there. So, no advancing in the plot yet. Although granted, one heavenly Punisher is defeated. But Drakenjo is still heading towards Eden Ozero. So, whatever victory the crew is going to have against Madame Curie, I wouldn't say it's victory until they have actually managed to save Eden Ozero from Drakenjo. And it's very high probability that they won't. So, the despair is still hanging in the air. As I said before, my one and only complaint about this chapter is Madame Curie dominating Shiki. It's not supposed to happen. Stop doing that. If you're doing that just because Homura is the one to take over the fight, then just make her show up already. I know she's still in her heroic BSOD, but I was hoping she was gonna recover after Rebecca's words. After all, Rebecca seems to know Homura more than Shiki. All this time, bathtub bonding may have something to do with it. Next chapter is called The One That Carries On The Soul. That actually may be a reference to that Homura is going to be back. Because if you think about it, she may proclaim that she will become the next Valkyrie. The most popular fear right now is that Homura is going to change herself into an android. or as I prefer to call it, a cyborg. So the way she, the title, the one who carried the soul, could very well be her declaration that she will inherit Valkyrie's legacy. After all, she is the student of Valkyrie. But that is just a theory. It could mean anything. Regardless though, Weiss came to the rescue, but now he is naked. And I do not want that. I prefer female naked, not the male one. But Pino's final line in this one, the a legend has begun. That is kind of funny. The naked hero is indeed born. I did not know that Weiss was such a fan of this moment. So that's basically the chapter. Do give me your thoughts if you have any.